looking at the iGPS Sport 520, comparing it with the 320. This is the bigger one, the 618, but also the 620 is bigger. And we compare it with the Garmin 1030 Plus, the Hammerhead Karoo 2, and the Wahoo Element Bolt 2. Like $270, $400, I think almost $500, nah, I think $450 nowadays. This is $140, the iGPS 520. It can connect to Strava, of course. You need the app. You have like it is nice, it's good readable. You can set up the light, by the way. It doesn't have the color screen like the 620 and the 618, but that's just, yeah, you don't pay the premium price of, I think, almost $200 for this one. You have, you like all kind of screens, little bit of navigation. You get two buttons on the right, two at the underside, like Garmin, of course. You have to mention Garmin, I think. One on the left. I don't think a lot of people will like this on the front. Most people want really this or this or this. But you get like the Garmin connection, so you get this when you buy it. You can buy it in really a couple of settings, so with heart rate monitor and cadence, and without. And without is of course the cheapest. This is just a Garmin connection, and yeah, it's sturdy, it's very good on the steer, but iGPS is also very big on the product. So this is the new 320, around $100, but it just has those two buttons, but it has the USB-C, which the 520 doesn't have. It has the old micro USB, so that's one thing to consider. Also, it does have like the plasticky look, not as premium looking as the 320, with a little bit of the glance black stuff here, which is also on the Wahoo Bolt 2. But it is more like Garmin 520 looking. So the older Garmin, really flat, as you can see here, also a little bit sleeker, as you can see. I just turn them around for you, so there we go again. Let's just see them on the front, so like that. So I think you can get really good opinion about them. I hope you liked the video. Wait with a thump. Yeah, it just the bleep, I think you can turn that off. You need the app, of course, iGPS with it. Then you have lots of functionalities for like half the price of a Garmin product. Yeah, like I said, they are a little bit of a copycat, of course, of Garmin. Yeah, that's just the way they do it, and they, yeah, it seems that they can get along with, yeah, in the Garmin market. I think there is a lot of people who like the Garmin products, but it's kind of expensive, of course, like always. What I do on this YouTube channel, I review the most expensive bike computers, also like other cycling products like shoes, gloves, clothing, and of course the bike itself. And just, yeah, want to do that for you. Hope you liked the video. Please subscribe if you want to see everything about cycling stuff. And see you next video. Thanks and bye.